NA1SS, NA1SS. This is K2CCW. How do you read? Over. Are you ready for the first question? Over. Are you ready for the first question? Over.
We are ready. Over.
How does your body adjust to living without gravity, and what changes will you feel when you return to Earth? Over.
So your bones and your muscles begin to get weak right away, which means we have to exercise every day to keep up that strength, because we're basically just floating around. We're not having to work against gravity. And once we get home, our body feels really, really heavy for the first few days. Over.
How significant is the threat of solar weather to the crew on the space station? Over.
How do you train or prepare for mechanical problems during a mission? Do you need plumbing, welding, or electrical skills to make necessary repairs? Over.
Absolutely. We fix things all the time up here. So before the mission, they actually send us to our Ellington Airfield, and we train with the guys, the maintenance techs, working on the jets, and learn how to fix electrical systems, fluid systems, everything. So we were ready when we got up here. Over.
We've read different descriptions for the odd and unique smell encountered in space. Have you experienced this smell in the ISS? If so, how would you describe it? Over.
Absolutely. When we opened the hatch from our Soyuz to enter into the ISS for the first time, I smelt this burnt electrical smell, and I said something right away, and the folks that were up there said, yep, that is the smell of space, which is essentially atomic oxygen hitting the material on the outside of our Soyuz. So it was really interesting. Over.
What will be the biggest thing to give up when having to leave the space station and return to Earth? Over.
That's easy. Floating to work every day and floating back home. Over.
What changes are seen in plants grown in space compared to plants grown on the Earth? Over.
One of the changes we've seen is that when the plants do not have a gravitational cue and there's no gravity, they will grow in many different directions, very differently from how they grow straight up and down on Earth. Other than that, we see very similar mineral composition, but the protein expression is different. And so that's something we're also studying on the ground. Over.
Experiments on plant growth have occurred on the ISS. What could this mean in the future for sustainable farming practices, both on space and in Earth?
So because on ISS we have limited water, limited space to grow plants, a limited amount of room for any sort of nutritional content or soil, it teaches us how to be very, very efficient and how to grow plants the best we can with the smallest amount of resources. And that can definitely translate back to Earth. Over.
What would happen if there is a serious medical issue with one of the astronauts? If someone were to get injured, is the recovery process of a wound any different, longer, or shorter than it is on Earth? Over.
Great question. It seems that in the past, people have noted that wounds tend to heal a little more slowly up here in space than on Earth, but they still heal in the same way. That being said, we have lots of medical supplies up here, and we get special training in case someone gets sick. If someone gets really, really sick and we need a lot of help, then we will come home as a crew. Over.
What are the hardest parts of your job on the ISS? Over.
Honestly, the hardest job I have up here is being away from my family for so long. We get to see them once a week with a special video conference and talk to them on the phone every now and then. But that is really tough to be away from your family for a very long time. Over.
How do electrical systems on an international space station work even without an actual ground? Over.
That is the first time I've gotten this question up here, and it's a great one. And what I can say is that we actually use the hull of ISS as our electrical ground. Over.
What is the hardest thing to describe about space to someone who has never been there? Over.
Honestly, it's really hard to describe how we do daily tasks of living, like brushing your teeth, washing your hair, even going to the bathroom. You have to develop a new way to do all of these things without any gravity there. And it takes a couple weeks to get really efficient, but you get there. Over.
Does sleeping while strapped down feel much different than sleeping in your bed at home? Over.
It really does. You don't get that feeling of when you finally lie down at night and you get that relaxing feeling and all your muscles can relax at home on Earth. You don't get that up here. You just kind of close your eyes and you're floating at night just like you're floating during the day. So it definitely feels different. Over.
If offered, would you join the first group of pioneers to make a habitable territory on the moon or on Mars? Over.
I would love for us to be able to head back to the moon. It's, number one, it's very, very close to Earth. It's close to home. You can see your home from there. And I think the only way we as a nation or as a planet is going to learn to live off the planet is to live somewhere close by first. Over.
How much radiation does your body experience in space, and how does the structure of the ISS protect you? Over.
So you get about 1 to 2 millisieverts a day up here in space, and I don't know if that value means anything to you, but over a long 6 months, it's actually not that much. The shielding of the ISS is pretty high. It's got a thick hull, and that protects us. What also protects us is the Earth's magnetic field, and even though thin, the Earth's atmosphere. So really, while orbiting low Earth orbit, radiation isn't such a big deal. Where it will become a big deal is when we head out to Mars and we leave behind a lot of the Earth's protection. Over.
Can a cell phone be used, the ISS, to call Earth or another space station? Over.
Great question. I've actually never tried. We are not allowed to have our cell phones up here. I guess theoretically, utilizing satellites, you could probably come up with something. But we essentially have Skype-type phone calls once a week with our family, and we utilize satellites for that. So it'll be interesting to see what they come up with in the future. Over.
What are some of the health risks living on the ISS for an extended time? Over.
So certainly radiation, like you mentioned, is one of the biggest health risks, especially once we leave low Earth orbit. Even though we exercise 2 hours a day, our bones and muscles still aren't quite the same, and our body produces proteins based on many different cues, and one of those is a gravitational cue. And so we need to study long-term what happens to the body over many, many years in space to see if more things change. But as far as we've seen, people do pretty well living up here. And it takes a little while to get adjusted once they get back, but they get there. Over.
Well, Serena, we've run out of questions. This is K2CCW. I thank you very much for your cooperation today.
W from N1SS. It was fantastic talking with you guys today. Good luck with everything.
7-3.
Yes, it worked.